The vernacular of airports has become really sterile and cold, white, gray boxes of steel.
Airports are gateways, gateways to cities, gateways to regions. There's a case to be made that transportation facilities in particular should be welcoming.
And now all of a sudden we've got a material that's completely unique. Prince George Airport was a really important project for our firm because it was transformative in the way we realized how our work actually impacts the community. The location of the airport's unique in that you look out on the airfield across at a forest, and literally at times there's bears that kind of walk across the runway. So what we wanted was a building that really opened up so that it almost felt like you were standing on the side of the runway. And so how we use the wood structure and how we use the glass to basically do that became a really important part of the design concept.
It didn't need to be extravagant. So we very quickly realized that we could simplify the structure, make a nice simple post and beam structure out of it, and just focus on the detailing.
So the columns, for instance, in the building are sort of elliptical shapes that are shaved on one side. So they're really kind of a beautiful form, but they're still made out of engineered wood. And then we really wanted to, all of the ways we connected the wood to be quiet and disappear, where there's just a tiny steel pin that holds together blades of steel that are all embedded inside the wood. And it really transformed the look of the building.
Because we were connecting to a steel building, architecturally it all had to blend in. The way the two connected together was resolved through the corridor. You have wood on the left, steel on the right, and then as you go down the corridor, it alternates, it flips around.
Prince George is a very cold climate. By using wood, it actually solved a lot of our energy issues because wood doesn't transfer the heat the way that steel or concrete would. That was, I think, a milestone in the way wood buildings worked in North America. Ottawa is an important project in a different way. I said to my engineer, I really want to build this out of wood. What happened when I presented it to the client, this big group, they said, well, wood's a West Coast thing. We were invited back to expand the building, about $100 million expansion of the airport. The gap in time was about 6-7 years. And they started seeing images of our other airports, and the second time around, they were asking me to use wood instead of me asking them, and it made it great. On the airport property in Ottawa, there were a series of 1940s hangars during the war. So we realized, well, why don't we look at that wood and see whether we can use it? We used a lot of that reclaimed wood from the hangar to kind of make retail spaces, use it wherever we could from a more of a decorative point of view, and then we use new wood to make the structure. We have a rhythm of columns that support one whole curtain wall that looks out onto the airfield. So you have this sort of long pier. On one side is all this wood, and on the other side is actually the steel of what we had done in phase one. It almost feels like a magnet. You almost feel like people are moving themselves closer to the wood side. There's no doubt that people do sort of resonate with the wood areas of the building much more than other areas, and I've heard that over and over, and the client has said that it's their favorite part of the building, and that matters a lot. So it's been a success.
Raleigh-Durham is actually the largest timber or hybrid roof in North America at 320,000 square feet. The architecture of the building consists of a number of connecting waves, and the wood, of course, is easily curved, and so was chosen, as well as for its architectural appeal, to frame the roof. Using this connection, managed to bring the fabrication time, estimated fabrication time, from 17 to 11 months, which of course saved a lot of money. The wood itself had intrinsically a very good fire resistance. The connectors that we used were also concealed, so were therefore protected by the wood. So the timber component of the system, I would say, was probably the most fire resistant of the entire roof structure. And while the facility is huge, the wood certainly brings a warmth and a joyful element to the building.
There's no chance that modern science is going to catch up with the qualities of photosynthesis, and therefore any material that's ultimately grown by the sun is the most technologically advanced material we can use, so let's figure out how to use it in architecture.
I think timber is taking back its place. The development of connections and accurate fabrication has been critical in allowing us to do certain types of structures. It is, I think, at an equal level to the other materials now, as far as scale and versatility.
We're starting to see much more interesting sort of hybrid structures that are mixing wood and concrete and getting the best out of both materials. There'll be many different explorations on what's possible, and that means we'll get some really exciting architecture out of that. And that's sort of, I imagine, in the next 10, 15 years, going to really reshape the capacity for the structure to become part of a new, modern, innovative building that's stretching the imaginations and dreams of that community.